संजय मठ, मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वॉल्सन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग रिगार्डिंग द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ दिस थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज स्टूडेंट विल एबल टू डिफाइन द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम्स एंड प्योर सब्सटेंस एंड वर्किंग सब्सटेंस. The properties of the thermodynamic systems are two types: intensive properties and extensive properties. In the previous video, I am explaining regarding the thermodynamics. In that, I am related when going to the definition of thermodynamics. You have to check the transaction of heat, work, and internal energy of that system related to the different parameters of that system. So, related to that, there are two types of system I am explaining. System and surroundings. We need to concentrate the characteristics, we need to concentrate the properties of that related to that system, that is on the defined area, that is called as a system, and outside that concentrated area, or that is called as a surroundings. So when you have to go for the thermodynamic systems, what properties we can study? The properties you can study: the pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy, electrical energy, magnetic energy, vibrational energy, rotational energy. Some are measurable one and some are non-measurable or negligible ones. So when you have to go for the properties of that system, the properties are of two types: intensive properties and extensive properties. Intensive properties are those which are independent of that mass, their own properties of the system, of that matter, that substance. Which are they? These are temperature, pressure, density, viscosity. So these are the intensive properties of that system. And when you talk about extensive properties of that system, they are independent, they are dependent on the mass of that system, they are dependent on the quantity of that system, they are dependent on the quantity of that system, that is called as extensive property. Which are they? These are the volume, mass. So when you have to go for the intensive property of system, a simple example is a room. In that pressure, a room is there and the pressure P is there. And if that room is divided into two parts, the pressure remains the same in the room 1 and room 2. Previously, whatever the gas in that room is to be there, the pressure P is there, the pressure volume V is there, the temperature T is there, the density rho is to be there. If that room is divided now into two parts, but the values are not changed, means they are not related to the mass of that system, they are not related to the quantity of that system. These are called as intensive properties of that system. In the intensive has a, there is a definite value, it shows that definite value. They are independent mass of that system and they are related to the point functions. So what is a point function, what is a path function, that I am explaining later on. So these properties are intensive properties. These properties are not related to the mass of that system, they are independent mass of that system, and these are temperature, pressure, volume, viscosity. And when you have to go for the extensive properties of that system, in the extensive properties of that system, they are dependent on the size, they are dependent on the mass of that system. It should be noted that the ratio of the two extensive properties, they are homogeneous one, heterogeneous one. That properties I am explaining later on. So here, which are the homogeneous system and which are a heterogeneous system? A heterogeneous system in the thermodynamic is defined as whose chemical composition and physical properties are the same in all parts of that system. Homogeneous means it remains the same, which are whose chemical composition and physical properties are the same. You take example of the air, whose that chemical composition and physical properties are the same one. On the other hand, when you have to go for the heterogeneous one, in the heterogeneous system, it consisting of two or more bodies, homogeneous bodies are to be there. If you take example of water, that water is mixed with ice, that is a heterogeneous one. And the homogeneous one, it remains the same, its chemical composition and physical properties are to be the same one. That is a homogeneous one, and that is a heterogeneous systems are to be there. Now we go for the definition of the pure substance. Pure substance. We need to go for the study of thermodynamics. Whatever the transaction is to be going on, that is related to heat and work, that transaction of heat and work, you have to require some media, and that media is called as a substance. So fixed chemical composition throughout in any phase, that is a pure substance. Means what? You take example of water. It is a mixture of two or more substances, but it still remain in a pure substance. That is a homogeneous form. That is example of water and ice. Means you take example that if the phase transformation even take place, the water, it called as H2O. That is a liquid form. Ice, it is in a solid form. Again, it is called H2O. Then what is called as a gas system, again it is called as a H2O. It is a vapor form, again it is a H2O. So even the phase transformation is to be takes place, it remains, that chemical composition remains of things, it remains to be defined by H2O. Even in the solid phase, even in the liquid phase, even in the gas phase, that is called, that is the same. It is to be noted by H2O, H2O, H2O. Even it is liquid phase, gaseous phase, or in a solid phase, that is called as a pure substance. Then you go for a working substance. Working substance means it is remains in the gas or liquid form. That is a fluid substance. It carries the thermodynamic processes by change in the temperature, pressure, volume, density, all these properties they have to carry. It is also known as a working fluid. Why it is called as a working fluid? Because when heat is added, expansion is going on. When heat is removed, compression is going on, contraction is going on. When heat is added, you get the work output system. You take example of in your house, the pump is to be there. For the heat pump, you have to supply that work. When the heat engine is to be there, you get the work output system. So these are the working media you have to require, that is called as a working substance. So when you know the pure substance, when you know the working substance, when you know the homogeneous system, when you know the properties of that system, then you give some example for this working substance. Think over that. So working substance is that it is the exact state of that matter, that substance. Suppose you go for a graph of pressure versus volume. You go for a graph of temperature versus heat supplied. That is one state, one is to be there. That state is a working substance and it denotes its parameters. That is a pressure P1, volume V1, temperature T1. That is the exact condition of that system, that is called as a state. And the condition of the system is described by certain values. That is a pressure, that values are P1, V1, T1, U1, H1, Rho1. So it defines at minimum two properties of that system. It defines, then it knows its characteristic of that system, exact position of that system. That is a working substance. That is a refrigerant, coolant, working gas, steam in the steam engine. So when the number of changes occur in the succession, then the complete series, that is called as a path. Means the working substance moves from one equilibrium stage to the other equilibrium stage, from state 1 to the state 2, from the state 2 to the state 3. When the state 1 is to be there, that working substance having minimum two parameters, you can know it. If a pressure versus volume graph is to be there, P1, V1, you can note down it. Then it moves from state 1 to the state 2, from one stage to the another state. From state 1, it is an equilibrium condition. When you go for a state 2, equilibrium condition. Some transaction is going on from state 1 to the state 2. That is a P2 and V2. So this is a definition of the working substance, pure substance. Okay. Thank you for that. The basic references used for this, that is basic books used, that is a basic mechanical engineering by R.S. Kurmi.